Capricorn friends, and welcome to your horoscope for July of 2020, where Capricorn, this month, your ruling planet, who is still retrograde, is actually going to come retrograde back into your sign, asking for a rediscipline, a reorganize, a redefining of your energy, your home, your relationships. All of these things become a conversation that has been on the table, but you're going to go back to. But the beauty of going back to what you're looking at is that you have seen it with different eyes. You've had a couple months to see some things with different eyes. And as you step back to it, to see what needs to be reorganized or redefined, you're doing it from a basis of wisdom. And I absolutely love that for you, Capricorn. I think it's beautiful energy. As well, Mercury is still retrograde as we come into this month in the energy of Cancer, which lights up all the seventh house stuff. Things, thoughts, emotions around relationships, not just romantic relationships, conscious, chosen, one-on-one relationships, relationships where it's like, I'm not even sure if you are my friend or you're my enemy. These have definitely been some things that have come up to the table, especially I keep seeing things with business as well. Business has maybe been something that's been really, really changing for you here, Capricorn, and you've needed to see these relationships from a different perspective. The retrograde has allowed that, and then you can make some decisions moving forward as Mercury comes out of retrograde. Not to mention, we've got an eclipse that also kicks us into this month as well in your sign. So there is some shifting. There are some disturbances that happen, but the disturbances are not fear-based. They're about we need to kick out what's here and get the course changed and corrected for the next 6 months. So let's jump in here, Capricorn, and talk about what's going on this month. Now, before I tell you that, actually, Capricorn, don't forget, we've got all of these eat and greets going on over here, and I am loving bringing people to you. So if there are things you're wanting to learn about or you're curious, put them in the comment section down below, and I'm sure I can find us a good old-fashioned friend to come over and talk about that with us. As well, the solstice gifts are still available if you're looking for a check-in coming up in the summertime, towards the end of the summertime at this particular point. Okay, Capricorn, as we come into this month, July 1st brings us this Saturn retrograde traveling back into your sign. So Saturn is literally coming back and saying, we have worked on this for a few years. You've seen it. We've refined this area. We've refined Capricorn. You have changed. Your identity has changed. Your physical body has maybe changed or is even still in the process of changing. There has been a discipline that has come to you. There has been sometimes a discipline that feels like a limitation, I think, Capricorn. But what has also been brought to your table is this reorganization of Capricorn that makes it so you've got a solid foundation to stand on, to succeed, to take you to the next level of what it is that you need to be learning and experiencing. So as Saturn comes back, this is going to tighten this up. It's like, let's make sure everything's buttoned up. Let's make sure we've got things together. But I do consider that as Saturn moves between signs, my experience is that it tends to have kind of an exodus when it comes back into a new sign or jumps forward into a different sign. So something could really be happening is that your physical body is changing. Like maybe you're having a detox or maybe you're having like an emotional clean out. Not to mention 4 days later, we're going to have this full moon lunar eclipse also happening in your sign, which says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So I just feel like this is like a flushing in some way, shape, or form for you, Capricorn. It's just like whoosh. Let it go. Put it down. Let those old emotions go. Let the pent-up frustration go. Let how you've been showing up go, and let's start to show up differently. Let's start to participate in your success moving forward differently, right? So it's really an interesting eclipse. Now, this eclipse is not going to just last 4 weeks. Instead, it's going to last 6 months. And the thing about this eclipse that I really want to point out to you, Capricorn, is that because the sun and the moon are in opposition here, and then we have this configuration in the sky that allows us to see full color, full view, things that we couldn't see or maybe we didn't want to see, right? One of the things I think of is because this is first house, this is going to show you a lot about you, Capricorn, for the next 6 months. If you have not been feeling free, if you have not been feeling the motion of progress, this is going to demand that you look at you and say, is what you're doing working? It is not contemptuous. This is not fear-based. It is simply, is what you're doing working? And if it's not, you're going to have to come to the table with a different attitude and arrangement and willingness. And a lot of that will have to do with how you interact with other people, how you let other people in. Are you accepting other people's help? Maybe there's even a dependent or something like that that depends on you. And you're really having to see that. But what it also gives you license for over the next 6 months is to allow this new identity that has been refined by your ruling planet Saturn to unfold into where you need to be for this next level. It's a much higher level of integrity and living, and there are good things that come with it, okay? On the 11th, we're going to see Chiron take his retrograde in the energy of Aries, and he's going to start his retrograde here and be that way until December. Now, in the energy of Aries, this lights up your fourth house space, Capricorn. This is home, right? Home, family, real estate, property, women in your life, family members. Now, Chiron is our deepest wound. It's our deepest wound. It's our deepest fear, but it is also our greatest teacher. So as Chiron retrogrades, we're going to go back to something deep in this area, and we've been afraid of it, right? It's been about the identity. Maybe have you been, you know, where have you had your identity attached to in this home area, and now it's shifting? You know, do you have somebody new coming into your home? Do you have somebody going out of your home? And it's like, it's been so, your identity has been so grounded in that, that it's like, I don't know how to be different. And this retrograde says, to thine own self be true, Capricorn, to thine own self be true. What is right for you at this point? And what is right that you found out from the lunar eclipse that you can step into this difference in your identity, something new, something that you were able to shed and put down so that you can move forward? Because even if we think at this of this at a very mundane level, Capricorn, it's like, okay, maybe you were single and now you're coupled up. Maybe you have had a very close relationship with a parent and now they are sick. Maybe you weren't a parent and now you are. As we change who we are, these identities have to shift and mold and come with us because we are essentially something different. So whatever this looks like for you, this Chiron retrograde is going to take you into the scary, but it's also going to help you revise and put down the identity that's not working anymore so that you can, to your own self, be true. On the 12th, Mercury is going to come out of retrograde in the energy of Cancer. Remember the stationing day, so the day that it's changing direction is always the hardest. There's a fair amount of instability that happens there. In Cancer, this is the energy of the seventh house, conscious chosen relationships, one-on-one relationships. I can tell you that while Mercury's been retrograde, you have been rethinking, getting a new perspective, having different conversation in relationships, in day-to-day things that need to get done. And I don't think that all of them have been exactly pleasant or easy, but there's been some definite conversation about some shift that needs to happen here. Now, as Mercury comes out of retrograde, you're able to make some decisions in your conscious chosen one-on-one relationships. How are you going to proceed forward? I keep getting this sense too, if you have to sign a contract or do something legal, as Mercury is direct towards the end of the month, this is a better time to do that. And you have a lot more clarity as well, especially if in the relationship, your head and your heart have been going in two different directions. And it's like, what do I do here? As Mercury is direct, I think your head and your heart come more into alignment, and that brings the clarity as well. Because this is Cancerian energy, Capricorn, I would tell you, pay attention to the women in your life. Pay attention to maybe what women are trying to teach you at this time as well, because it may be something about trying to ground your security down, and you could stand to do some listening or to even adding some value to what somebody else has got. If you have relationships that are just fundamentally flawed and not meant to be there, I don't think that you will have as much energy to try and piece and patch them back together. Instead, this may be a time with Mercury direct that you see from a forgiving perspective that it's time to let that go. And if the relationship is healthy, you'll have lots of chat going on, no doubt. Now, we're also going to have a new moon happening July 20th at 28 degrees of Cancer as well. So plant your seeds of intention in the area of your relationships, in support, in how you need to be loved and how you need to be held, in the friendships that you want, in the area of relationships and how you show up in relationships. What do you want here? Plant these seeds of intention at this new moon, and we'll watch over the next 4 weeks as they blossom. But do keep in mind that Saturn back in your sign asks you to be absolutely accountable for how you show up in the desires that you're calling into your life as well. And if you you do that, man, what comes from that is something big and beautiful. Saturn says, do the work, I'll drop you the gifts, right? Now, as we close out this month, we see the sun moving into the energy of Leo. He's at home in Leo. So this is bright, this is shiny. It's in the eighth house, joint resources, intimacy, sex, birth, death, rebirth, all of those things are happening. So again, a lot of this month, as I see it in the physical Capricorn form, I think speaks to a lot of detox, a change of the body in some way, shape, or form. And as the sun is here in Leo, it is big, right? It is big, it is bold, it is generous, it is done with joy, it is seeking to bring joy into your joint connections with other people. There is to be joy in this lifetime. And maybe if you've forgotten that, gotten away from that, it felt heavy. You were feeling like, I don't know what I'm going to do with this money. If the eclipse brought changes to career or to business areas of your life, I think the sun in Leo gives you the motivation and the understanding on how to shift those things and take advantage of opportunities, especially joint resources that are good for everyone going forward. But it'll also just give you the motivation to move, right? Leo is a fire energy, so it will give you some courage to move forward on joint decisions that you need to make. Now, this could be for some of you as well, changes to finances with a spouse or with someone or something that you are partnered up with. Let's say you were doing unemployment or something like that, and that takes a shift. This will create the shift for sure, but then it will also show you an avenue out to re-navigate around that. So not a dull month. I don't think it has been a dull couple years for you, Capricorn. The surprises and shocks and twists and turns that you have encountered, I think especially in terms of relationships and you in relationships, I think has been immense and intense. And this month I think is no less than that. But this time you're moving from a position of so much more wisdom, if you'll allow yourself to step into that, and if you'll allow some people to step into your world as well. It is a social month. There will be conversations to be had. So go out and get what you need for yourself this month, Capricorn, okay? I'm sending you lots of light, lots of love. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I'll see you in the eat and greets and the solstice appointments, my Capricorn friends, all right? I love you. I'll see you next month. Bye.